Thank you. That concludes the debate on Scotland's housing emergency. It's now time to move on to the next item of business, which is a debate on motion 13230 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill, Emergency Bill Motion. And I remind members that as per Rule 11.3.1H of Standing Orders, the question on this motion will be put immediately after the debate, and I invite members who wish to speak in the debate to press their request to speak buttons. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to speak to and move the motion up to 4 minutes, Minister.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. I seek Parliament's agreement to treat the Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill as an emergency bill. The Post Office Bill seeks to ensure parity of justice for sub-postmasters in Scotland who are excluded from the scope of the UK Bill. Despite the Scottish Government providing the UK Government with the straightforward amendments that would have extended the scope of that bill and their decision to extend its provisions to Northern Ireland, they chose not to do this. Therefore, it's clear that we need Scottish legislation, and we have introduced that this week. The Bill's proposals mirror those of the UK Government in allowing for sub-postmasters with relevant convictions in Scotland, as defined in the Bill, quashed the day after royal assent is obtained. Scottish ministers will take reasonable steps to identify these convictions and notify the person in the court that the conviction has been quashed. A person whose conviction has been quashed will then have access to the UK Government redress scheme. It is imperative that Scottish sub-postmasters, like others across the rest of the UK who were convicted of offences based on tainted Horizon evidence, have their convictions quashed and are therefore able to seek redress as quickly as possible and in line with those in the rest of the UK. As a result, Scottish legislation needs to be in place as soon as possible after the UK Bill is passed, but only after its final form is known, so that we can take account of any amendments made. The UK legislation is proceeding through Westminster, but we don't have the final timetable for that yet. As Parliament is aware, we have a very different way of taking forward legislation to the Westminster process. Whilst the UK Government can take forward bills in matters of months, sometimes less, our processes normally take a little longer. I'm sure that none of us will want that to be the case for this bill, which will ensure sub-postmasters can seek compensation following the quashing of their conviction in the same time frame as their UK counterparts. Therefore, I hope Parliament will agree that this bill must be an emergency bill. Presiding Officer, I also hope members will understand we're seeking to have a bill that does not do anything to jeopardise equality and parity for victims. So whilst we are keen that we progress the bill quickly and have timetabled stages 1 and 2 of the bill next week on the 21st and the 23rd of May, stage 3 cannot be considered in the Scottish Parliament until after UK legislation has been passed to ensure that MSPs can take account of any amendments made to the UK legislation. The commitment, though, is that we will bring forward stage 3 as quickly as possible following the UK bill passing. Whilst I would hope that would be before Parliament breaks for recess, we should remind ourselves that the UK Parliament does not rise till mid-July. Presiding Officer, I will conclude by saying the Scottish Government has introduced this bill swiftly, is now seeking Parliament's agreement to ensure it passes at pace too. I'm sure that I speak for all across the chamber that sub-postmasters in Scotland and indeed across the UK have waited too long for justice, and we must make sure that those in Scotland have full equal access to the UK compensation scheme as soon as possible too. I therefore move that Parliament agrees that the Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill be treated as an emergency bill.
Thank you. And I now call on Alexander Burnett. Up to 3 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer, and I'll keep my remarks brief. The prosecutions of Horizon scandal victims have been an emergency for some time. And over the last few weeks, Douglas Ross has tried to bring Scotland's most senior law officer, the Lord Advocate, to this chamber to clarify her comments. And after voting against our attempts to make this happen three times, the Scottish Government has finally conceded, and it is right that the Lord Advocate will answer questions in the chamber tomorrow. It is important that the victims of this injustice have a clear, unconditional commitment from the Scottish Government, including from its law officers. Postmasters have waited too long for justice and have been let down by the SNP's game playing of manufacturing a grievance with Westminster when everyone knows that Scots law is devolved. The bill itself acknowledges the nuanced changes required by the Scottish legal system, and the Scottish Conservatives have been calling on the SNP to step in and get on with legislation to overturn these prosecutions for months. We therefore welcome that the Scottish Government has finally introduced this bill, and we will support this motion, which will allow the bill to be expedited. However, we would like the Scottish Government to go further and commit to passing this legislation before summer recess. There is no need to wait and see what other governments do. Scotland has the powers to resolve this now. That is the right course of action, so let's get on with it.
Thank you. I now call on Martin Whitfield, up to 3 minutes, please.
I'm very grateful, Presiding Officer. And from this side of the chamber, Scottish Labour will also support this motion because emergency bills are unusual within this Parliament, and as the Minister said in opening this short debate, the way that we process law is different to other places, and so it should be because this is our Parliament. But we do need the opportunity at times like this, at times of imperative nature, at times to move legislation as soon as possible that the facility exists, and it does. And so the support from this side of the House for the motion, and indeed I hope the bill, once we've had a chance to have a look at it, will also follow. My question is in relation to the specific standing orders that deal with emergency bills, which is Rule 9.21. Rule 9.212 talks about the Parliament deciding otherwise on a motion of the Parliamentary Bureau, which is what we have before us today. Stages 1 to 3 of an emergency bill shall be taken on the same day. The motion that sits before us explains that stages 1 to 2 will take place on specific days next week, which is of course acceptable, but the motion is silent as to stage 3. And thus, for completeness, we've had an undertaking from the Minister that it will pass as soon as possible, but I wonder whether we could rectify what is possibly, and I'm more than happy to give way.
Minister.
First of all, I welcome Mr Whitfield's commitment to backing the motion today. I've set out the necessity, of course, and I think he's recognised the need for us to take this forward as an urgency. Also, that we would have preferred to be able to complete that process on as quick a basis as possible. Indeed, we're still committed to that. In relation to the point that he makes, I'm, of course, very happy to pick that up directly with him, and if we identify it as a necessity for any further motion to come back, we can of course discuss that and agree that at Bureau next week.
Martin Whitfield.
I'm very grateful for that intervention and indeed the undertaking to rectify what may be a textual problem, but I think given the nature and the rareness of emergency bills in this House, and because of the travesty and the length of time that our post office owners, operators and workers have had on this, we should put nothing to risk with regard to this one. So, to reiterate the support from this side of the House, I will conclude my subject at this point.
Thank you. I now call on Maggie Chapman, up to 3 minutes, please.
Thank you, Presiding Officer. The Scottish Greens fully support treating the Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill as emergency legislation. We consider the scandal that has led us to this point to be a series of appalling miscarriages of justice, of poor governance, or the failure of trusted institutions on which sub-postmasters, their families, indeed all of our communities, should have been able to rely. Never again must the lives, reputations and freedom of those working hard and honestly for their communities be sacrificed to defective corporate systems. We welcomed the apology given by the Lord Advocate earlier this year, but an apology is not enough. Those who were convicted of crimes in the scandal must have their convictions quashed. So we support the principles of the legislation we will discuss next week. But legislation is not enough. We still need answers about how prosecutions were dealt with in Scotland, including the role of the Post Office and the significance of the evidence admitted under the corroboration rule. We need clear and accessible compensation for those unjustly accused and for reimbursement of sub-postmasters who made payments to rectify Horizon errors out of their own pockets. We need to explore prosecution for those responsible for the fiasco and for the recovery of relevant awards, rewards and bonuses. And of course, we must make sure that we learn from this about the outsourcing of sensitive systems to profit-driven corporate entities and about the safeguards necessary in relation to increasingly privatised agencies. But for now, we have the legislation about the quashing of convictions. We must deal with this quickly. So I support today's motion and look forward to our stage one and two discussions next week. Thank you.
Thank you. I now call on Alex Cole-Hamilton.
Thank you very much, Presiding Officer. Scottish Liberal Democrats support the introduction of this legislation, of course we do, but this has taken far too long. Opposition parties have been asking for the Lord Advocate to come to this chamber to explain the government's intentions for weeks, and with every delay, we only increase the anxiety of the Scottish sub-postmasters at the heart of this. The government wasted time on a spat with the UK government when it should have been doing all it could to get victims the justice they deserve, and with good haste. And too much of this process has been defined by confusion as to whether the government backed blanket exonerations in the first place. For the sake of the victims of this scandal, I am very glad we are finally making some progress towards that clarity. Presiding Officer, this has been one of the most appalling miscarriages of justice in our national story. Lives and livelihoods have been ruined. One Scottish victim spoke recently of how he planned suicide and had to be sectioned due to the trauma he had experienced. He is still on medication for depression as a result. He said the government's lack of clarity around whether he would have to go to court individually to have his conviction overturned had made matters worse. Former post office workers across all four nations have tirelessly pursued the justice that they have been denied for so long. We owe it to them to move forward now. Members of the public, the press and government officials were repeatedly lied to on an industrial scale deception on the part of the post office. Scottish Liberal Democrats are pleased that emergency legislation to clear the victims of this scandal is now being brought to this Parliament. We know that around 100 people may have been wrongly convicted by the Crown Office and Procurator Fiscal Service in Scotland based on evidence provided by the Post Office itself. I am glad to see that this bill will mirror the UK bill, because every step we take away from that legislation risks delaying Scottish justice for the Scottish victims. It is vital now that they get the justice and the redress that they are entitled to, and as quickly as possible. It is the very least they deserve. Thank you.
Thank you. That concludes the debate on Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill, Emergency Bill Motion. And there's one question to be put, and that is that motion 13230 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill Emergency Motion be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13218 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on Post Office Horizon System Offences Scotland Bill, timetable and procedures for consideration. Any member who wishes to speak on the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak on the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 13218 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13217 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau, setting out a business programme, and I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you. No member has asked to speak on the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 13217 be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of business motion 13219 in the name of Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau on a Stage 1 extension. Any member who wishes to speak on the motion should press their request to speak button now. And I call on Jamie Hepburn to move the motion.
It moved, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. No member has asked to speak on the motion. Therefore, the question is that motion 13219 be agreed. Are we all agreed? The motion is therefore agreed. The next item of business is consideration of Parliamentary Bureau Motion 13220 on committee meeting times. And I ask Jamie Hepburn on behalf of the Parliamentary Bureau to move the motion.
Move, Presiding Officer.
Thank you, Minister. The question on this motion will be put at decision time. There are 7 questions to be put as a result of today's business. And the first is that amendment 13196.3 in the name of Jenny Gilruth, which seeks to amend motion 13196 in the name of Pam Duncan Glancy on Stand Up for Teaching be agreed. Are we all agreed?
Yes.
The Parliament is not agreed, therefore we'll move to a vote, and there'll be a short suspension to allow members to access the digital voting system.